Hello, I'm Pete Gerlach. I'm the author of the nonprofit Break the Cycle website, The Cycle of Inherited Psychological Wounds and Ignorance, which is passing down our generations. The website is a series of 8 self-improvement lessons based on what I've learned over 31 years of being a family therapist and 70 years on Earth observing all of us human critters. In this video, I want to introduce a couple of real key points that will underlay and form a foundation of communicating effectively with any young people in your life. This is the first of 2 videos. The third video will offer some ideas about communicating effectively with teenagers. So what I'm about to say applies to all kids. And you will probably find what you're about to experience in this video is different than any other book, video, any other source. First, I want to propose, see how you feel about this, all behavior in person A that causes a, quote, significant, unquote, effect in person B, psychologically, physically, or spiritually, is communication. Not just talking and listening, far more. So the way you behave around your children is communication. You communicate all the time. Because of that, the very first and most powerful thing you can do to form a foundation of effective communication with any young people in your life is to put yourself in charge of your dynamic, amazing, unique personality. You might say, well, I am in charge of my personality. That's a popular misconception. And if you study lesson 1 in the Break the Cycle website, you'll find out more about who really runs your life. Is it your true self, which you'd like to believe, or could it be a protective, myopic, false self? Most ineffective communication between people in general, and adults and children in particular, happen because the adults are ruled by false selves. They've inherited psychological wounds from their ancestors and they don't know it. So the very first thing you can do to promote long-term effective communication with the young people in your life, study lesson 1, and strive to maintain your true self being in charge all the time. That's basic number 1. By the way, let me propose a definition of effective communication. We communicate to get our needs met. Fundamentally, that's why we do it. And from that, anytime 2 people in conversation each get their main current needs met well enough in their own, by their own measure, in a way that feels good enough to them. 2 conditions. Needs get met in a way that feels good enough. That is effective communication. Compare that to your present definition. Okay. Now, to communicate effectively with kids, lay the foundation by working to maintain your true self in charge of your personality. The second long-term foundation you can lay in order to promote effective communication with all people, including kids, study lesson 2 in the Break the Cycle website and learn 7 skills. My experience after studying communication effectiveness for 40 years professionally, my experience nets out probably 5% of average adults, whether they're college educated or not, know how to communicate effectively. They get by, but there's far more they could do if they knew what they were doing. Most people don't. Our ancestors didn't know these seven skills, neither did the school that you went to. I challenge you, I bet you can't name the seven skills. You'll find them in another video and in lesson two. So what I'm proposing is this. Put your true self in charge. Give yourself the task of learning to practice and model the seven communication skills with and for your children. Teach them these skills with the long-range objective in mind. Imagine them as young, independent adults in all kinds of life situations, being comfortable with their own self-esteem, as opposed to being shame-based or fear-based or guilt-based. That's what happens when you demonstrate a true self in charge and help your kids learn to trust their own true self. So imagine, as a young independent adult, each child in your life not only has self-esteem and they know how to communicate with a wide range of men, women, young, old, friends, lovers, business associates, strangers. Imagine that. Can you think of a greater gift to bestow on a young person in your life? Learn these seven skills, model them intentionally, and teach them to your children. As you do this, a final tip that I want to offer in this particular video is, be aware whenever you are with or talking to or about young people in general or a specific young person in your life. Be aware of your attitudes. An attitude is a good, bad judgment, right, wrong, like, dislike. It's a way of thinking about some person or thing. We all form judgments about each other. That's human nature. You may have been taught or acquired along the way certain attitudes about kids. For instance, someone in my family believes firmly, vehemently, kids should be seen and not heard. That's a very destructive value because, in effect, it does not encourage kids to learn to speak their minds and to assert their needs. The person I'm thinking of is unaware of that attitude and would defend it stoutly and argue that's perfectly all right, there's no problem with it. Yes, there is a problem with it. You have accumulated across your years dozens or even hundreds of attitudes about kids, boys, girls, young children, infants, teens. Your attitudes will leak when you are speaking to or in the presence of children. They will pick up from your face, your eyes, your words, your body language, how you feel about kids in general or them in particular. So my suggestion here is become consciously aware of the attitudes you carry about children. Write them down over time. Probably not something you do in one sitting. Write them down. Try completing this sentence over and over again. Kids are, girls are, boys are, compared to adults, kids are, I expect kids to, fill in those blanks and learn your attitudes. Then use your adult mature judgment to say, how would you like it if you received that attitude from an older person? Be alert for attitudes that are likely to shame or intimidate or frighten typical young kids. When you become aware of such attitudes, change them, upgrade them. You can do that. You may encounter some flack from people around you who believe what you used to believe. Your responsibility as an older person is to raise the self-esteem and the knowledge of the young people you're associating with. So, the three things I hope you'll take away from this video: to build a long-term foundation for effective communication with young people, all young people. Put your true self in charge. Study lesson one to see how to do that. Learn to practice and teach and model 7 specific communication skills. Lesson 2 on my website. It's free. And the third tip is become aware of your attitudes and change them. Get rid of any attitudes that are going to feel disrespectful to a child or that will make them fear you or dislike you. I hope you find these tips useful, practical, and I hope now you will take a look at some of the videos in Lesson 1 or Lesson 2, or go to sfhelp.org for more information. Thanks for watching.